Now let us solve one more sum. Let me read out the question for you. I have written only the data. So let me read out the question. The question says, the details of monthly sale of mobile phones in 1000 units and its profit in lakh for the last 6 months for a company making mobile phones are given below. So the last 6 months profit and sale of the mobile phone has been given to you. See, it is the data has been given to you. So let us compute the correlation coefficient between these two variables. Okay, so your x variable would be number of phone that is being sold, and that is in 1000 units. So like this you have to keep in your mind, that is 3000 units of phone, and the profit is in lakh. So there is a profit of 6 lakh rupees. Like this you have to say in your mind. Okay, this is in given in small digits, but in mind you have to say like this. For 8000 units it is 10 lakh rupees the profit. So like this it has been given to you. Okay, now you have to find out the correlation coefficient for this sum. Now let us find out the data that has been given to you. So how many this is given, what is your n would be 1 2 3 4 5 6. So 6 months, last 6 months it is given to you, data has been given to you. So n would be 6. Okay, clear with this? Then the next step you have to find out x bar and y bar. So the formula is sigma xi upon n, and y bar it is sigma yi upon n. So total of the column of x and total of the column of y, you would get 40 and 58. So dividing it by 6, that is your n would be, n is 6. So dividing it by 6, you would get your x bar as 6.67 and y bar as 9.67. So now what you have to see is, see your numbers, that is 6.67 and 9.67 is in decimal. So what I have said in my earlier videos, that whenever your x bar and y bar, that is your means, come in decimal units, then you have to adopt the second method. Okay, second method of Carl Pearson's product moment method. Again, the second thing you have to remember while taking this method, that your data are in small units. Okay, so the first thing it was, then whenever your mean come in decimal units, then you have to adopt the second formula. And also the second thing that you have to keep in mind while adopting the second formula is that your data should be in small units. So clear with this 2 point, decimal and small units. Now let us start with the second formula, that is this formula, this method. Okay, do you remember this method? I've said in my earlier videos also. So now let us compute this. Okay, so first you have to make 3 columns. The title is xy, x square and y square. Okay, so now how to find out xy? Xy means product of x and y, that is multiplying the column of x and multiplying the column of y, you would get your x, y. So you can see 3 6 are 80, 8 10 are 80, 12 15 are 180. Like this you have to multiply and get the total of this in the end. Okay, after calculating the x, y, you have to sum it up and your answer would be 431. Now the second column is x square. Now what is x square means? X square means x into x. I'm writing over here, x square is equals to x multiplied by x. Clear with this? And y square means y multiplied by y. Okay, you have to remember this. Okay, what is x square and y square? I hope it is clear to you. Now x square, 3 3s are 9. Clear with it? Then 8 8s are 64, 12 12s are 144, 5 5s are 25, 7 7s are 49 and 5 5s are 25. Similarly with y square. See, what is your y for the first month? It is 6, so 36, 6 6s are 36, 10 into 10, 100, 15 into 15, 225, 10 into 10, 100, 9 into 9, 81. Like this, you have to do the x square and y square column and then you have to total it up in the end. Okay, for every column you have to make the total. Okay, now let us come to the formula. What is the formula? R is equals to n into sigma xy minus sigma x multiplied by, your multiplication is there, and sigma y multiplied by sigma y divided by square root n multiplied by sigma x square minus sigma x the whole square multiplied by square root n into sigma y square minus sigma y the whole square. Clear with this formula? You have to remember it. Okay, now keeping this in keeping the values in this formula, we get 6. What is your n? 6. Sigma xy, sigma xy 431, sigma x, what is sigma x? 40, sigma y 58, then square root, again n is your 6, sigma x square, what is your sigma x square? 360 minus sigma x the whole square, sigma x is 40 the whole square. Similarly, again with y variable, multiply by square root, again n is your 6, sigma y squares, what is your sigma y square? 606 minus sigma y the whole square, what is sigma y? 558 the whole square. Okay, now you can calculate on your calculators. Okay, then afterwards you would get your answer as 266 divided by 283.7464. Clear? Then after dividing, you have to get, you will get the answer as 0.9375. Then you have to round it off and make it in two decimal points. Then your answer would be 0.94. So in your number line, see, I have made it clear by interpreting the R. So how is your chart goes like this? Okay. So, minus 1, 0 and positive 1. So, 0.94 which is lying over here. 0.94 which is nearer to positive 1. So, what would be the decision? The decision would be positive correlation. So, the variables of x and y are having a positive correlation between these two variables. So, clear with this sum? I hope it is clear to you. Right? Okay, now let us take another example. The question number 3. The question says, for 6 different cities of Gujarat state, the approximate figures regarding their density of population per square kilometer and the death rate, that is per 1000, are given below. So I am reading this question for you because I haven't written on this board because there was no space. So I have written only the data. So what is the question? For 6 different cities of Gujarat state, the approximate figures regarding the density of population and death rate has been given to you. So you have to find out the correlation between the density of population and the death rate. So let us compute this sum. Now, 6 cities has been given to you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So your n would be 6. So here I have written my n is equals to 6. Then you have to find out the mean, that is your x bar and y bar. So x bar, the formula is sigma xi upon n, and y bar is equals to sigma yi upon n. So find out this by adding the x column and y column, you would get your sigma xi as 2700 and sigma yi is equals to 68. Dividing it by 6, you would get your mean as 450 for x variable and 11.3 as y variable, as the mean of y variable. Now, what do you understand? See, this variable of y is been in decimal. So, and also, see, decimal, and also the units of the variable are also in large numbers. Okay, so which method you are going to adopt? The third method. Okay, what I've said in my earlier videos, whenever your units of the variable are large units and also you have your mean as in decimal, not in a whole number, not as a whole number or a natural number, then in that case you have to use the third method, that is UV method. Okay, that is the shortcut method that I've explained earlier in my videos. So let us move forward. Okay, Now, then you have to find out this columns 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 columns, and first one is U, V, UV, U square and V square. Now, for taking U, let us assume the A as 500 and B as for finding out B. For the V column, your B should let us assume as number 12. Okay, now to divide it by 100. Why we are taking 100? Because these variables are in the multiples of 100. That's why we are dividing it by 100 in order to get a single digit number. Clear with this? Why we are dividing it by 100 over here? Okay, now here we are dividing it by 1 because the digits are small. That's why we are dividing it by 1. This you have to understand and then go on. Okay, so let us calculate this. U is equals to the formula is x minus u. The formula for u is equals to x minus a upon what we are taking the cx as 100. So x minus a upon 100. And for v, we are taking as y minus b. B, what it is? Our b, we are taking 12 divided by cy. What is your cy? We are taking 1. So clear with this, the formulas. Now let us calculate. Okay, so while calculating, see, for the first city, that is your x is 200 minus 500 divided by 100. Do it in your calculator and tell me the answer. Your answer would result to minus 3. For the second city, it is 500. The variable x is 500 minus 500 divided by 0, divided by 100. Then your answer would be 0. Okay. Then 400 minus 500 divided by 100, your answer is minus 1. Like this, you have to do it for the rest of the other cities also. Okay. Then coming to the value variable v. Okay. So v is equals to y minus 12 divided by 1. So what is your y variable for the first city? It is 10 minus 12 divided by 1. Your answer is minus 2. Similarly, again, 12 minus 12 divided by 1 is 0. Again, 10 minus 12 divided by 1, we are getting minus 2. Similarly, you have to do for the other cities also. Then you have to make the other column named as UV. So UV means U multiplied by V. So the column U and column V, you have to multiply these two columns so that you can get the other column UV. Okay, so minus 3 into minus 2, your answer is 6. 0, 0 is 0. Minus 1 into minus 2 is 2. 1, 2 is 2 and minus minus plus. That's why positive 2. 2, 3 is 6. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. Minus 2 into 0, 0. Understood? Now you now got the column of UV. Then you have to find out U square and V square. So U square means U into U. Okay. V square means V into V. Clear with this? So U, where is your U column? This. So minus 3 into minus 3 is your positive 9. 0 into 0, 0. Minus 1 into minus 1, positive 1. 2 into 2, 4. 1 into 1, 1. Minus 2 into minus 2, positive 4. Similarly with V square, minus 2 into minus 2, 4. 0 into 0, 0. Minus 2 into minus 2, positive 4. 3 threes are 9. Minus 3 into minus 3, positive 9. 0 into 0, 0. Clear with this column? UV, U square and V square. Then afterwards, after completing this, you have to find out the total of each and every column. Clear with this? Then move on to the formula. So what is the formula? R is equals to N into sigma U V minus sigma U multiplied by sigma V divided by square root N into sigma U square minus sigma the whole square multiplied by square root N into sigma V square minus sigma V the whole square. Understood? Now, let us put the values, okay, in this formula. What is your N? Your N is 6. What is your sigma UV? So, where is your sigma uv? Here. It is 11 minus sigma u. Then, where is your sigma u? Here. Minus 3. And sigma v, that is minus 4. Clear with this? Now, square root. Again, n into sigma u square. N is 6. Sigma u square is 19. See over here, 19. Then, sigma u the whole square. So, sigma u. Where is your sigma u? This. So, minus 3, the whole square, multiplied by, again with the variable y. So, n into sigma v square. N is 6, sigma v square is 26 over here. Then, minus sigma v, that is v is minus 4, the whole square. After calculating, you would get the answer like this, 54 divided by 121.2436. Okay, then you will, after dividing it, you would get 0.4454. Then afterwards, you have to round it up. And your answer is, that is your R, that is your correlation coefficient is 0.45. Now, the last step you have to take is to decide whether it is perfect negative or perfect positive or there is lack of correlation. So, how you have to decide? You have to draw the number line like this. Minus 1, positive 1 and 0. So, in between 0 to 1, you are having 0.5. So, your answer is 0.45, which is a bit in the middle of 0 and 0.5. So, it is neither too nearer to 0, nor it is too nearer to 1, which is slightly nearer to the middle. Okay. So, what you can write? You can write either it is moderate, positive or lack of correlation. You can also write like this also. But I hope this would be more appropriate answer. Moderate correlation between these two variables. So you have to write in the end. That is to make your decision as that there is an existence of moderate positive correlation. You can write like this. Moderate positive correlation. Clear with this? The last decision would be like this. So, I hope it is clear to you.